Hello guys, welcome to our third lecture of dynamic memory allocation, where we are going to cover the program of how to create a dynamic 2D array, right? Earlier we did a program of creating a dynamic 1D array where we used a single pointer variable which was pointing to array of integers, right? Now here in the second program, we need to create a dynamic 2D array. First of all, I have a question that what is a 2D array? Yes, what's a 2D array? We know that 2D array is basically an array of one dimensional array. 2D array is array of one dimensional arrays. For example, this is your 2D array. So 2D array is basically array of 1D arrays. Here you have multiple one dimensional arrays. So 2D array is array of 1D arrays. Right? Earlier, we created a single one dimensional array. Now here, instead of creating single one-dimensional array, we need to create here the multiple 1D array. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to copy this one, everything. So we can do like this. Right, so this is your 1D array. I need to create the multiple one-dimensional arrays, like this. So this will become your second 1D array. Then, this will become your third 1D array. Then this one will become your fourth 1D array and so on. Right? Where each one dimensional arrays will have the multiple columns. Okay, so I just inserted these lines which specified the columns, so you can do the same, right? Okay, so this is your multiple 1D arrays. As you can see, when I created the multiple one-dimensional arrays, my this pointer variable also gets copied, right? What I mean to say is that in order to create a dynamic 2D array, you need to create an array of pointers. In order to create a dynamic 2D array, dynamically, you need to create an array of pointers, right? Where each pointer will point to its own one-dimensional array. So this is the concept of 2D array, right? Just like here, look here. Okay, before this, in order to store array of pointers, which variable we need to use? Just like if you need to create integer array, which is not a pointer, normal integers, we create a pointer variable, right? Where the pointer variable, we store the address of array, right? Now, here we have pointers. Here we have a pointers where in order to store, like I have copied this one, copy and then paste. Right, I need some another variable which will point to my this array of integers. So this is my complete array, right? So this one is going to be my complete array of pointers, and in order to create this array of pointers as well, you need to create this array of pointers also dynamically. Right, in order to create array of pointers dynamically, I also need another variable. And that variable will be your, which variable? Yes, this will be your pointer to pointer variable. Because you know that pointer to pointer or double pointer will point to your pointer variable. Like pointer variable can store the address of any variable. It can be the pointer variable as well. Right, so if one pointer is pointing to another pointer, then that pointer will be the double pointer. So this is going to be your scenario, right? First, you will create a double pointer, right? And that double pointer, you will make it point to array of pointers. Clear? So this will be your first dynamically memory allocation. Then, after this, you need to create another dynamic memory For what? For these array of integers, where each and every pointer, so this is your pointer to pointer, so this one is going to be a PTR of 0, PTR of 1, PTR of 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So here you will have unique pointer, where each pointer will further point to your array of integers. Now this way, this is going to be the same which we did earlier for the single pointer. You wrote int star PTR is equal to new int then in bracket size, right? So this is going to be the same for each and every pointer, right? Now let's look at the program. Initially, since this is a 2D array, instead of specifying the size, you need to specify the number of rows and columns, right? Where earlier there was only single row, but here you will have the multiple rows. So you will input the rows and columns from the user. After this, you need to create two dynamic memory allocations. First one will be for the pointer to pointer, this one, where this pointer will point to array of pointers, right? Then in the next step, you will create dynamically 1D array, where this 1D array will be pointed by each pointer of the array, right? Look here. So this is your pointer to pointer, which is pointing to your array of pointers, right? After this, you need a for loop. Why for loop? Look here. This is your single pointer, which is double pointer. Then this double pointer is pointing to array of pointers, where this dots, these are not the integer values, but these are also the pointers. This is a pointer 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? So just like earlier, we did this one. We created a single pointer, which was pointing to array of integers. Right? Where it was a single 1D array. Single 1D array. Now you need to repeat this thing for multiple 1D arrays, which is this one. So these are the multiple 1D arrays, right? And how many 1D arrays? That will depend upon your number of columns. Clear? So number of columns will be equal to number of one dimensional arrays. So that's why here we will write this thing inside the for loop. So for I equal to 0, I less than rows, I plus plus. Your PTR of I, now we will initialize that single PTR of I, just like you wrote here, PTR of I for every integer value. Same way here, for every PTR inside the array of pointers, you will write PTR of I is equal to new int of columns. Clear? Look here. This single PTR of I will point to single new int of columns. That how many columns you need here. Right? Then you will insert the array elements using the double for loop and you will write scene PTR of I and j, where I will be from 0 to rows and j will be from 0 to columns. Then in the next step, you will print the array elements using the again for loop. Now here you need to delete array of pointers, right? For the array of pointers, we will use this square bracket notation. Now let's execute the program. So here, now we are just at the top. Enter the number of rows. Let's say the number of rows are, let's say 5. Enter the number of columns. Let's say 5. Right? Now here, your program has allocated memory dynamically. Now in the next step, we are inserting the elements. So let's say that my array is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Then 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Then 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. And when you press enter, here you get your 2D array. So this is your first row, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Then in your second row, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. We are getting the same elements. So this is a concept of your dynamic 2D array. Clear? Execute this program on your own, only then you will understand. Right? Also consider this example as well. If you want, you can take the screenshot of this example. This diagram is very necessary. So when you will note down this program in your notebook, draw this diagram so that you will understand the program much better. Right? I hope the program is clear. And now in the next lecture, which is tomorrow, we will do the program for the objects, which is classes and objects. Right? Clear? So read the concepts thoroughly about the new and delete operator and execute the programs which we have done till now. Right? Thank you so much. Good luck and take care.